basically just trying to start every day with a little bit of movement, get the heart rate up, get things going, and really get used to playing around with this thing and kind of what effort equals what. This thing will absolutely fucking trash me. So, figure I'll probably do 10 minutes on here and then do some stretching and stuff like that. Your morning routine doesn't have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be killing you. It's just added. It's just a small routine done consistently. It doesn't have to ruin the rest of your day. It's just enough to get things broken and moving and snapping loose from basically all the time you spent sleeping. Just kind of get everything back woken up. I know I feel a hell of a lot more focused and ready for the day after I get done with it. We have a guest coming this afternoon, Andy Wong's on Munchies. He's awesome. He's gonna come this way this afternoon. We're gonna do a little bench workout, and then he's gonna work on me massage-wise, and we're gonna talk about kind of some of the things he does and maybe try to talk about a diet plan and what's gonna work for me this off-season. All right, it's not a shock to anyone here that I'm a bit of a coffee nerd, which I don't know. I like drinking coffee black, and I like French pressing and doing stuff like that. I like the whole ritual to it, and it's delicious. I had a roaster approach me about possibly doing some hate brand stuff, testing some stuff out. This is like a Brazilian roast. Pretty good. It's light. I've also got like a Sumatra and an Ethiopian, stuff like that, and then some different roast of those beans. Trying to figure out which one I like best. I am going to try to pick a coffee that I like that's delicious. I'm not looking for something over caffeinated and tastes like acid. Really just trying to go for good. I want good coffee. So we'll see how it works. What do you guys like? What do you think is coffee wise? I like the Ethiopian stuff like that. Like it's really good because there's kind of some fruity notes to it and some different shit like that. So may as well drink good stuff. So work meetings and stuff like that, I can't go dress like a scumbag, so I have to actually wear normal clothes. Jesus, that's far away. But it's good. It's a good change of scenery. Otherwise, I have a tendency to be a real shut-in, so. This at least gets me out of the house. But New Orleans is about, well, Chalmette. Chalmette's about an hour and a half away, so that's where I'm headed. This is like first day of fall stuff. It's like 66 outside today at like 8:30, which is normally 80 degrees outside. So really, really nice. I love fall. I know that's a controversial thing to say to people, but it's just so nice not to sweat all the goddamn time. Okay, I gotta hit the road. Down in New Orleans waiting, or not New Orleans, I'm actually in St. Bernard. So for anyone not from Louisiana, I'm in New Orleans. For anyone from the area, I'm in Chalmette, or Moreau. Waiting for my meeting. Got here way too early, like an hour to kill in Chalmette, which is, I don't know what you do with an hour in Chalmette, there's not much to do. But the meeting should be good, and it's really nice outside, so it's been kind of cool. Just trying to get a little work done while I've got some free time and talk with Mike about some of the upcoming hate brand good stuff, as well as trying to plan some stuff out. I know we're going to have a booth at Jesse's Meat in November. I don't know if I'm going to be there. I don't know what's going to happen with knee surgery, so I'm just kind of waiting for that to determine my schedule. all in all, really nice day out. I'm glad I'm not stuck in the house, but I need to get home. Gonna train this afternoon with Andy Wong and go over some stuff, try to get learned on a bit. I picked this local sushi place in Chalmette, 4.5 stars on Yelp. Now, why is the screen all smudgy? Question begs. Does Yelp weight differently? Like, is 4.5 stars in Chalmette the same as 4.5 stars in San Francisco? Probably not. Buy the ticket, take the ride, adventure. All right, I'll say this. I was fully prepared to bash that place. Fucking sushi was good. Sashimi was really good. So, Chalmette, you got a gem in Umi. Quality stuff, tastes delicious. I'm so full now. I ate all the sashimi. I'm so full. It's like perfect. It's like 80 degrees outside. I could just take a nap. All right, we gotta get all the way back home. That's quaff. I had to do something. I gotta let my hair grow a little bit. It's winter. No more progress yet. That was a healthy piss, Bo. Work. And Willie, go pee. Puppy piss party. That's how I live my afternoons. I'm ready to get out of these fucking clothes, though. Done with that for today, and got an edit done. And I got a friend. There he is. We're gonna lift some weights in the garage. So much room for activities. Found out I have another swole brother there in Baton Rouge. This is Andy Wong.
What's up, guys?
You're gonna have to come closer unless I switch lenses. So, Andy lives in Baton Rouge from California?
San Diego.
Nice. And apparently it's really strong. What are your lifts?
My best squat is 804 in sleeves, bench 501, and my best deadlift is 832.
Shit.
And my best total is 2126.
That's incredible. At what, 275?
275.
Awesome. So, we've ran like this for a long time, and now we're like this. And we're gonna do some bench today. And then some bro stuff, because I don't have a plan right now. Are you in some type of prep right now?
I am in prep.
Okay.
We're in the beginning. I'm about 14 and a half weeks out.
Okay.
So it's still a long, you know, a long time from the heavy duty stuff. But we're trying to transition into like 4 to 6 rep range right now.
Okay, cool. So we're gonna do some stuff. So watch some upper body, and then we're gonna talk about some diet stuff and. Since Andy's kind of in the same world as me, a big guy, 275, and has always been a big guy, we're going to talk about some diet plan for me with his off season and surgery coming up. Finished off bench, Went to some incline bench, something I've never done in the garage before, so that's new. Did some banded dumbbell stuff, a couple sets of 10-12. Trying to figure out this, how to win the hypertrophy. And I think we're gonna do some shoulders now. I think we're gonna do some snatch pulls. So I know how to do those. See how it goes. That's the whole workout. We did some bench, some incline dumbbells, some snatch pull slash upright row type maneuver. We did strict press and some dips. Sweet. I'm gonna probably do that more often so that I can chase a bit more of the pump this off season. We're gonna focus on a couple different goals, and Andy and I are gonna go inside. He's a It's not traditionally a massage therapist. Oh my God. You gotta stay back there, you gotta angle me. No, yeah.
Hey, Matt.
Yeah. It's like I have Baton Rouge's Bart Kwan with me. So you're what, a massage therapist or?
Massage therapist, but you mostly practice neuromuscular therapy and active release technique.
Okay, I know about active release. Explain neuromuscular therapy, because I'm not smart.
It's more like just, to simplify, it's more like trigger point work. Okay. Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah.
We're gonna go and work on a bit of that and get real comfortable. And then we're gonna talk diet stuff and things that can help me not be so fucking dumb. I know I've done this before, but now I have someone local who's also a big guy who can help
me. I'm on his shoulder.
Yeah.
Put that shit down.
Yeah, you have to be less fat.